Great chance to meet another young gun as he continues his journey. It's Luke Evans. What say we take a look at his highlights? He's got great vision, and for a young man, he's super calm in heavy traffic. With more control and get smart, Evans drives it forward. You could watch him all day. Brilliant change of pace right there. He's 30 out, 20, 10, and you'd have to say that's...
Turn him out of perfect, right, Dennis?
Whatever you say, Luke.
Welcome back to TAC Cup Future Stars. We'd love to have a look at family links here on TAC Cup Future Stars. And it's time now for Close to Home for Sweeney Estate Agents. The can-do agents. Visit Sweeney Estate Agents for all your real estate needs. Darren and Wayne and their wonderful team doing great job across the city. And sweeneyea.com.au. And let's get into our family this week. Brad Crouch, unprecedented pick by the Adelaide Crows in their history to give up to get this young man, superstar talent. His younger brother Matthew is at the Ballarat Rebels and touted Shifter as a first-round draft pick this year. They are two of the great young players in the comp, in the AFL landscape. And boys, welcome to the program.
Yeah, thanks for having us, Hutchie.
Thanks, Hutchie.
Great to have you along. First to you, Brad. A fascinating story. We followed you closely in your time in TAC Cup here on the program. Adelaide gave up a pick two future selection to get you into the system, so you went a year early and couldn't play. How's it been for you at the Adelaide Crows?
Yeah, I've settled in pretty well, to be honest, Dutchie. Yeah, I guess it was a big year last year, not being able to play AFL, so I played at West Adelaide and I was lucky enough to have a really good coach and a really good club around me, West Adelaide. And, yeah, I had a great year. We played in a grand final, which we lost to Norwood, which was a bit disappointing, but to play sort of senior footy and sort of get ready for AFL was a big step up for me, yeah.
Now, was it tough going over as a 17-year-old to Adelaide and being away from your family?
Yeah, it was. I think the first month or so, it was pretty tough. It was a bit different. I've never been away from home, so first month I was living with another player. I was living with Richie Douglas at the time, so then moved in with a host family. I had a great host family. And so they were really good for me. They made me feel real comfortable, and the club was great, and I've settled in really well now.
Brad, I just want to speak about that West Adelaide experience, because I've always found that coming through the TAC Cup, you're playing only against boys, basically, and then all of a sudden you get to the stage of playing against men. How did you find that jump?
Yeah, it was pretty big, to be honest. I remember playing senior footy when I was about 15 or 16 at a sort of local level, which is a bit different, obviously, because... yes, AFL is a pretty good standard, as you know. So I guess the big bodies and obviously the quicker tempo and stuff like that, I was really lucky to be exposed to that a bit earlier than what I could have been if I had been playing under 18. So I guess that helps me a little bit in sort of getting ready to play AFL this year.
Now, Brad, I want to bring Matt in on this one too to see who will answer this one. But I read when you were coming through about the famous one-on-ones at home, backyard and the lounge room, ball put in the middle, and it always ended in tears, whether it's mum's tears or one of you two. How long did that go on, and who was the winner in that little battle?
Yeah, I'll take that. Yeah, we used to do that a fair bit at home. We used to put the footy in between us and go hell for leather. So I guess when we were young and that, we enjoyed doing that sort of thing. I think it helps a bit when you're out playing footy now and the competitive sort of streak, you need to play a good footy.
Good answer. I don't know if there'll be any challenges there. Matty, just in regards, obviously you're touted as a first-round draft pick this year. Do you think that experience of going through the draft process, everything from getting a manager and then becoming part of the AFL system, do you think it'll be made easier knowing what your brother's been through?
Yeah, for sure. I think with all that, I guess I've got a bit of experience off Brad. He's told me a lot about what the expectations are and that sort of thing. So. With Brad's advice and speaking to him a fair bit about it all, I reckon that'll help a fair bit.
And you've had your own couple of little frustrations through the early part of this season, just getting your body right, but everything okay now?
Yeah, broke my hand about 7 or 8 weeks ago, which is disappointing, and then missed about 8 weeks with that, so it's good to be back out there now and playing footy.
You're obviously different players. Are you competitive against each other still?
Yeah, we still are pretty competitive. Just before I come over to Adelaide, when I first got drafted, I missed the first week of training because I had I had sort of side effects from concussion. He whacked me one. he whacked me one before I come over, and I sort of couldn't remember what happened.
What do you mean he whacked you one? Where were you?
He can't me.
Just fighting in the backyard.
Yeah.
Still doing it.
Yeah. Thought the old man got in between us, and he sort of come over the top and. Yeah, got me pretty well.
So you sort things out in Ballarat, is it?
Yeah, that's how it sort of...
Pretty simple.
That's how we sort things out.
When you saw your brother taken in the mini draft at pick two, you must have been pretty proud when to see the price a club would pay. I mean, we're seeing Adelaide now saying he's one of only two or three players in the list who aren't up for grabs in this trade period. Must make you proud of your big brother.
Yeah, it did. Yeah, at the time I was wrapped for him. So at the time it was pretty exciting for us all, the family and that. And we're pretty happy the way he's going. Hopefully he can keep going pretty well.
Now, Brad, looking at your under 18 years up at the Rebels, some of the guys you played with, the influences up there, what do you recall from your days?
I didn't play too many. I think I ended up playing maybe 8 or 9 games for the season. I remember hurting my leg and during the championships, and also had a pretty good crew with me. I know Seb Ross from St Kilda, as Dale will know, he's a ripping kid. Nick O'Brien, my best mate. He's at Essendon, obviously, and he's playing today. He's backing us for his first game this week, so I know. I guess
you going to watch him today?
Yeah, I'm going to have a look today. So, it's good to see him and him in. And I guess that's what you find. I guess when you have a couple of good mates and you hang around together, you sort of all want to. I guess you all want to play AFL footy eventually. So, I guess we all sort of do that in the end.
And you followed a similar path to Paddy Dangerfield, who was taken also a year early by the Crows and stayed in school though in Geelong, country Victorian like yourself. How big an inspiration has he been for you, and how much do you benchmark yourself against him?
Yeah, he's good, Danger. Yeah, he's been great for me. Like he's very easy to talk to, and he'll talk to you about anything. And often it's not about footy. He's really good off the field, but I know he's a massive one. He really talks about how his sort of first couple of years were really like he really had to develop, and he didn't exactly dominate from the word go. And as you see now, he's a superstar. But I guess that didn't happen for the first couple of years, and it's only sort of been the last year and a half where he's really started to dominate.
And Matty, it's been a hard year for North Ballarat. Are you looking forward to the season finishing? Are you nervous about the whole drafting system?
It's been a hard year for North this year. We've got a lot of young fellas, so we're still developing. I think Deeks and Phil Partington down at the Rebels are still doing a good job with the boys. We've got a lot of underage kids playing, so... I think next year will be pretty strong, and with the draft coming up, I'm just obviously looking forward to it. I'm just doing the best I can.
And no surprise to see Crouch best player for the Rebels. They go down, and my spies telling me nearly 40 possessions yesterday again in a side that was thrashed. A couple of good players for the opposition. Jarman Impey, who Matt you played with, he must have had a good game. He's a good player for Vic Country during the year and was a good player for the Bushies yesterday.
Yeah, Jarman played another good game. He's a good running carry through the midfield. He killed us yesterday, so he went well.
And Michael Gibbons, a good player for the Bushies, a star for New South Wales during the championships. And Max King, the number 23, a big tall fella from the Bushies. He's kicked bags of 4-3 and then 4 again yesterday over the last 3 weeks. So he's one to look out for late in the draft, I would think.
It's great to see you boys going well. Please exit without fighting each other through security. We don't want any more injuries or accidents around the place. And Brad and Matt, thanks for coming in. Matt, good luck with the draft at the end of the year. And Brad, good luck with the Adelaide Crows for the rest of the year. The Crouch boys now, Sweeney, close to home. A great family of football they are indeed from Ballarat.